Here, what you see is the wildlife here. Feel free to pause, because this is just going to be a quick through. Hey, this thing's talking.
Yeah?
Shh. What we got here? Oh, there's a lot to go through here. What?
I don't know. You're in the way.
Is an overall view of the Fort Duchard area and covers approximately 8 to 10 miles, although it is not to scale. The Mississippi River in front and the limestone bluffs in the rear mark the boundaries of the settlements. The long narrow strips of farmland extend back towards the lakes, marshes, and bluffs from a surveyed line drawn along the King's Highway. These long lots are characteristic of the French settlements in North America and still can be seen today. The fields were 1 or 2 arpents wide and up to 40 to 50 arpents deep, an arpent being equivalent to 192 feet. This land was known as the common fields. Each individual farmed his own land, but the entire common fields were enclosed by a fence, which everyone had to assist in building. This fence was necessary because in the winter the cattle were led into the common field to graze, and then removed in the summer to the pasture.
That's where the fence would be.
The village of Saint-Philippe was built on land granted to Philippe Renault. Renault was in charge of the lead mines in Missouri, and the farms at Saint-Philippe were started to raise crops and cattle to feed the miners. Below Saint-Philippe was the Mishigamia Indian village. The Mishigamia were one group of the Illinois Indians. To the right of the Indian village is the Coulee de Nau. The Coulee is a cutoff of an old river channel. It marked the boundary of the reserve set aside for the Indians by the first commandant of Fort Duchard in 1719. Although both the first fort and the third stone fort are shown, these would not have existed at the same time, but they are shown so that you can see their positions. The location of the second fort is not currently known. The village of Chard was the center of social life for the French settlers. Unlike the later American farmers, they did not live on outlying farmsteads, but preferred village life. The village was occupied by the farmers, craftsmen, military officers, and some soldiers. The Church of St. Anne was the parish church for the village of Chard.
Mom, let's talk about that church we just at.
And St. Philippe, extending from St. Philippe to Prairie de Rocher, and then on to the village of Kaskaskia, which is beyond the area shown here, was the Chemin du Roi, the King's Highway. This was the official government road. Every able-bodied man in the area was required to work on this road 3 days per year. The village of Prairie de Rocher, the Prairie of the Rock, was settled soon after the village of Chard. Prairie de Rocher is the only remaining settlement in the Fort de Chard area. Fort de Chard is now one of the
you got a paper? I figured you would.
Oh, I...
Yeah, I would, yes.
Excuse me, I don't know how you...
It's not even a rotary.
Not even a rotary.
I don't think they have... Did they have a rotary phone?
I'm surprised they even got that in there.
I know. I know what we're talking about.
Jeez.
Yeah.
The old landline phone.
Yeah, that's the...
Okay.
Incandescent lights, too.
Those are the
13
times.
Right here.
And then over here, you can get a little magazine.
Starts all the way back from the early, late 1600s and goes all the way up to the late 1990s. Where did we go? Now this is something you don't see very often anymore. Old payphones, which hasn't worked in years. Old vintage. And here, what's this say?
That should look a little funny.
Yeah, it doesn't work. All right, let's go.
I need the plant clips. Did you get this one?
No, I'm good. Just...
I was getting the last pamphlet.
Alright. Thanks for watching, y'all. We'll see you next time. And before I go, just want to remind y'all that Jesus loves you and have a wonderful day.